Hello students, in our previous class we have discussed about the consideration. We have discussed what is consideration and what are the essentials of valid consideration. We have seen that how important consideration is. So consideration is the foundation of every contract. Whenever there is a contract or whenever there is an agreement, promise, which is without consideration, it is considered as null and void. Null means as if it is not in existence at all. Void means not enforceable by law. So whenever there is an agreement that is without consideration, such agreement is null and void. According to Section 2D of Indian Contract Act, agreement without consideration is void. So we have seen that for formation of a contract, how important consideration is. An agreement without consideration is considered as nudum pactum. Nudum pactum means such an agreement, such a promise which does not have any value in the eyes of law. So this is the importance of consideration. But there is a rule that no consideration, no contract. But there are certain exceptions to this rule. So rule is no consideration, no contract. If in any contract there is no consideration, we cannot call it as a contract. That agreement will not be a contract. But there are exceptions to this rule. That means there are certain agreements, even though in case of those agreements, even though there is no consideration, that agreement can be converted into a contract. Now, which are those points? One by one, we will first discuss those points and then we'll discuss the explanation of those points. First, natural love and affection, compensation for services rendered, time barred debt, completed gift, agency, guarantee, and remission. So, in these seven cases, even though an agreement is made, even though without consideration, such agreement becomes a contract. Now, one by one, we will discuss these points in detail. First point, natural love and affection. So, whenever an agreement without consideration will be valid. When an agreement without consideration will be valid? When it is made, when it is expressed in writing, when that agreement is made in writing, registered under the law for the time being in force, made on account of natural love and affection, and it is made between the parties standing in a near relation to each other. So, an agreement without consideration is valid when it is made in writing, it is registered, it is made due to natural love and affection between the parties, and it is made between the parties who are in a near relationship to each other. Near relation means the relationship by blood relation or relationship by marriage, that is called as near relation. So an agreement without consideration is valid if it is made in writing, registered, it is made due to natural love and affection, and it is made between the parties in a near relation to each other. All these essentials must be present to enforce an agreement made without consideration. So whenever there is an agreement without consideration, not only a single but all these four essentials must be present. It must be writing, it must be registered, it must be made on account of natural love and affection, and between the near relationship of the between the parties who are in a near relation to each other. So example of this natural love and affection: A. A person, out of natural love and affection, promises to give his son 1000 rupees. A. Puts this promise in writing and he registers it. So this contract is a valid contract even though it is without consideration. In return to 1000 rupees, son is not giving anything to his father. He is not doing anything for the father. But father is giving 1000 rupees to the son without any consideration, without anything in return. So no doubt he is doing it out of natural love and affection. They are in a near relation to each other. Father made it in writing and he registers that agreement. In this case, even though in this agreement there is no consideration, that agreement is a valid contract. Now, second point, compensation for services rendered. So, whenever there is an agreement which is made without consideration, and that agreement is made in order to provide the compensation for services which are already provided by a person, that agreement, even though it is without consideration, it is a valid contract. An agreement made without consideration may be valid. When it is made, it is a promise to compensate either wholly or in part. So when one person promises another person to compensate that person, either full compensation or part of the compensation he is ready to pay, to whom? To a person who has already voluntarily done something. So to that person who has already done something and he has done it voluntarily, out of his own wish and will, the promisor not has asked him to do that thing. He has done it on his own, done something which the promisor was legally compellable to do, or he has done something which was the duty of the promisor. Promisor had to do that, but that person has voluntarily done it. Then promisor says that I will compensate you, I will pay some money to you. In that case, that agreement is, even though it is without consideration, it is valid. Example of it is to apply this rule, following essentials must be present. Which are those essentials? The first thing is the act must have been done voluntarily. So the promisee or the person who is doing an act for the another, he must have done it out of his own wish and will. Promisor has not asked him to do that thing. The act should have been done for the promisor and not for anybody else. So the act must have been done for the person who has given a promise, not to any third party. The promisor must be in existence at the time when the act was done. So when the act was done, the promisor must be in existence. And then the promisor must agree now to compensate the promisee. So promisee has already done something for the promisor, which the promisor was legally entitled to do. Promisor had to do that legally. He has done it. He has voluntarily done it. It should be done for the promisor and not to anybody else. Example of it, A finds B's purse. So B's purse is missing. A finds that purse. A knows that it is the B's purse. The purse belongs to B. And A goes and gives that purse to B. Now, A has already done something for B. He has voluntarily done it. B has not said anything to him. He has voluntarily returned B's purse. Now, after getting the purse, B says that I will pay you 100 rupees as a reward, as you have returned my purse. Now, here for 100 rupees, B has not done anything. He has already voluntarily done something for B. Now, in this case, afterwards B promises to give 100 rupees by way of a reward. Now, it is a contract between A and B, and A can claim 100 rupees from B as if there is a contract between these two parties. So, this is about the compensation of services which are already rendered. Third point is time-barred debt. Now, what does it mean by time-barred debt? So, for repayment of that debt, already time is gone. Now, the creditor has no right to ask for repayment of that loan from the debtor. That such debt is called as time-barred debt. So, whenever there is a promise to pay time-barred debt, a promise to pay time-barred debt is also enforceable. It is enforceable. So, the A has given a loan to B. So, B has to repay that loan, but the date for repayment of the loan has already gone. In spite of that, B promises to repay that loan to A. Such promises enforceable by law. Condition is that the promise must be in writing. It should be signed by the promisor and or his agent authorized in that behalf. The promise may be to pay whole or part of the debt. So, A has given 10,000 rupees to B by way of a loan. B has to return it, but already time for repayment of that loan has gone. In this case, even though time is gone, B has nothing to give to A, even though B promises to repay the loan to A. Now, in this case, that agreement has to be, that promise must be made in writing, and it should be signed by the person who is making the promise. And in this case, even though it is without consideration, it is a valid contract. An oral promise to pay time bar debt is unenforceable. So it should be in writing and it must be signed by the promisor or his agent. Next point is completed gift. So the rule no consideration, no contract shall not affect the validity of any gifts made between the donor and the donee. Donor is the person who gives the gift, makes the gift. Donee is the person to whom the gift is given. So this rule is not applicable to the gifts which are made between donor and donee. Thus, gifts do not require any consideration. So, say for example, there is your friend's birthday is there, and you give some gift to your friend on his birthday, his or her birthday. Now, there is no consideration. Even though there is no consideration, it is a valid gift. It is a valid gift, valid contract. So, you cannot put a condition that today I am giving this gift to you, and in consideration, in return, on my birthday also you have to give me a gift. No. Even though there is no consideration, there is a valid completed gift, or there is a valid gift. Agency. Now, who appoints an agent? Principal appoints an agent to act on his behalf. Section 185 of Indian Contract Act says that no consideration is necessary to create agency. So, in case of agency, even if the agent agrees to act as an agent of the principal without remuneration, that agreement is valid. So, in case of agency, the rule no consideration, no contract does not apply. That means where a person has agreed to act as an agent of another person without remuneration for the work, the relationship of agency between the two, that is principal and agent, will be created even if agreement is without consideration. Next point in that is guarantee. In case of contract of guarantee, so contract of guarantee, guarantor is the person who gives an assurance or guarantee to the creditor with respect to repayment of the debt which is taken by the debtor. So in contract of guarantee, there will be three parties: guarantor, debtor, creditor. Guarantor is the person who is giving guarantee or assurance to the creditor that debtor will repay the loan. If he does not repay, I will repay the loan. In case of contract of guarantee, guarantor does not get anything either from the debtor or the creditor. Even though there is nothing in return he is getting, that contract of guarantee is a valid contract of guarantee. Contract of guarantee is made without consideration, and as per section 127 of Indian Contract Act, even though it is without consideration, it is a valid contract of guarantee. Seventh point, remission. So, as per section 63, no consideration is required for an agreement to receive less than what is due. This is called as remission. So, remission means what? Remission means when one person agrees to receive less than what is due. That is called as remission. And in case of remission, no consideration is required. Remission means, again, I will give an example. A has to give 1000 rupees to B. A does not have 1000 rupees. B knows that A does not have 1000 rupees, but he has 700 rupees. B says that, okay, you have to give 1000 rupees to me, but as you don't have, you give 700 rupees to me, I will think that you have given me 1000 rupees. So he has become ready to accept, receive less than what is due. That is called as remission. In case of remission, he is accepting less than what is due, but in return, he is not getting anything. There is no consideration for remission. Even though there is no consideration for remission, it is a valid contract. So these are the exceptions to the rule no consideration, no contract. If you see previous year's question paper, this question is often asked for 5 marks. Thank you.